Hi everyone, I'd like to present my LEGO automatic motor shutoff and alarm system. I'll start by giving you a quick demonstration. On the left we have a motor, and on the right we have an output. When I turn the battery on, you can see that the output spins. However, if I apply a load to the output, you can see the motor turns off and the alarm system turns on. The alarm system is built using the older 9-volt sight and sound bricks. And for the moment, I'll turn the siren off. To reset the system, I can move the switches back to their original position, and I can also manually turn the system off by moving the switches. The battery box feeds power into the switches in the middle, and the switch on the left powers the motor, whereas the switch on the right powers the alarm. The two switches are joined together with a linkage in the middle so that only one switch can be turned on at a time. So either the motor is spinning or the alarm system is on, but not both. The motor feeds power through to the output via an axle. However, in the middle of that axle, there is a clutch. The clutch is constructed using a pin connector, and into that is inserted two axle pins with friction. And then two axle joiners. This will want to spin as one unit. However, if you apply enough force on one side compared to the other, then it overcomes the friction in the middle, and then they can spin independently. And this creates our clutch. On the left, we have a set of gears, which is two 24-tooth crown gears. Because they have the same number of teeth, this is a 1-to-1 gear ratio. On the right, we have a set of three 16-tooth gears. And again, because these have the same number of teeth, this is a 1-to-1 gear ratio. However, because there's two gears on the left and three gears on the right, it means that they spin in opposite directions. These two subaxles then feed into the differential cage in the middle. But because they've got the same speed, but in opposite directions, the differential itself does not spin, but the spider gears do spin. You can see that in action here. When you apply a load to the output, it slows down this half of the system. When that slows down, it causes a difference in speed from the left side to the right side. And that difference in speed causes the differential to spin. When the differential spins, it causes an axle down the bottom to spin, and that's connected to this yellow linkage, and then the yellow linkage is connected to the switches. I'll run it through it a few times so you can see this in action. Watch the differential cage, and you'll see that it moves just a little bit. Next, watch the yellow linkage, and you'll see that it also moves just a little bit when I apply a load. And then finally, watch the position of the switches, and you'll see that that moves as I apply the load. For a vehicle, the loads typically change a little bit as you go over an incline or over a bump, so this system is probably not very good for that. However, for systems where the load is constant, such as a Great Ball Contraption, this system will allow it to automatically shut off if the Great Ball Contraption encounters a jam somewhere. When the motor shuts off, the alarm system turns on, notifying the operator that there's an issue. Then they can come and fix that and reset the system. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments to this video, and thank you for watching.